This home behind me in Borrego Springs is where a sexually violent predator was accepted Friday to move into. Despite this decision from a San Diego courtroom, neighbors here tell me they're going to continue to fight this.
We live in sort of a Mayberry out there. You know, it was the kind of place where the kids go run around and, you know, come home when the street lights come on.
Residents on Running M Road in Borrego Springs tell me they know everyone in their tight-knit neighborhood.
This is actually a very quiet community, quiet neighbors, children, families.
But this community is getting a new unwelcomed neighbor, 69-year-old Michael Martinez, a sexually violent predator.
My heart dropped. Jeez, what is this? Why are they doing it in Borrego Springs?
San Diego Superior Court Judge David Gill approved moving Martinez from a hospital to this home, something neighbors have been protesting, and many of them drove hours to hear the verdict Friday.
Horribly disappointing. You know, feels like a violation of our community fabric, you know, getting torn apart here.
Betty Dean lives the closest to where the sexually violent predator could call home and invited us inside to show us what she can see from her kitchen window.
These two windows are part of a bedroom. It's a four-bedroom house, so it's a big house.
Her garden and window faces Martinez's new home, and she's even considered moving.
I'm going to try the 7-foot fence up there and put it all so it'll go right there, and so that I won't be able to see most of that, and I'm hoping they won't be able to see me either.
Martinez was diagnosed as a pedophile with personality disorders and convicted 4 times between 1979 and 2004 in both San Diego and Los Angeles counties in cases involving child molestation.
Heartbreaking. Frustrating. There's no words to explain the feelings as a mother.
Jennifer Arias and her 2 young boys live a short walk away.
I'm feeling kind of nervous if he's placed here.
San Diego County Supervisor Jim Desmond said in a statement after Friday's ruling, quote, "This is a dark day for the community of Borrego Springs and for many residents whose lives will not be the same. I will continue to fight to protect our communities." This community says they won't stop fighting either.
Happen. Hopefully, they find a mistake or something. That's what I pray God.
The state says Martinez is subject to measures including GPS tracking and surveillance, to name a few. In Borrego Springs, Zara Barker, Fox 5 News.